My final paper for film theory class evaluated the causes and implications of video playback speed functionality on streaming players such as Netflix and YouTube, and in this video, I aim to explain the logic behind my theory argument as well as demonstrate it. Netflix introduced the functionality at the end of 2020 in the US, allowing for playback speeds of as low as 0.5 speed and as high as 1.5 speed. And it royally annoyed creators because it interferes with how they believe their work should be seen. YouTube allows for up to 2x speed, and certain players like VLC Player and Chrome extensions allow for many times those speeds. I work in television, and believe me when I say most broadcasters speed up shows by about 1 to 3%, which is an imperceptible amount to viewers, but allows for more advertising. It's roughly one 15-second ad per 1% increase in a half-hour show. Let's look at two examples, an episode of Breaking Bad and the film Crank, to see what characteristics in film allow for faster playback speed.
What are you doing?
Driving through a mall, cubs chasing me.
Crank has so much going on in terms of the visual information being transmitted to a viewer, including speed of montage, mise-en-scène, aka the objects included in a shot, and hypermediation, that it would be tough to watch this at a faster speed than intended by the directors.
If I'm right, they gave you the Beijing cocktail.
Very nasty shit. It works on the adrenal gland, blocks its receptors. The only thing you can do to slow it down at all is to keep the flow of adrenaline constant.
Meaning, if you stop, you die.
Hang on!
On the other hand, Breaking Bad takes its time with long shots, focusing on character reactions and creating feelings such as tension. Also, the shot composition tends to be simpler. The role of social media cannot be overstated in the addition of playback speed functionality to streaming platforms. Platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube use experimentation, algorithms, and big data analysis to steadily increase the addictive nature of social media over time by improving the performance on metrics such as time watched or time spent per day. This ethos has spilled over into streaming services like Netflix, which views itself as competing with sleep. Allowing viewers to watch content faster means more content consumed, more ads delivered, and so on. Neuroscience backs up that humans can be trained to process visual information at a faster rate, which I go into detail in my paper. I argue that not only does social media train faster visual processing speed, but also the increasing speed of montage in film and television does. Using a database of 7,000 films since the 1930s, I show average shot length has steadily decreased by roughly 1/10 of a second per year. As a result, viewers have been trained on, and in turn expect, a certain speed of media. Otherwise, a film is slow or boring. Kuleshov was right on the money in a couple ways. First, the fast speed of montage is a reflection of American capitalism, which we can see with the blockbuster films that are cut very fast and are action-packed to keep audiences' attention. But he was also right when he said that American audience demanded those faster speeds. Our neurology can handle significant amounts of visual information, especially with training. In fact, during this video, I've steadily sped up the speed and tried to simplify the background to decrease visual complexity. Perceptive folks may have noticed, but my hope is that with this experiment, many of you did not. If people can subconsciously become accustomed to faster playback speeds within a single video, I hope you can see how years of visual and psychological conditioning through social media and action-packed films can lead to changes in the speed of visual information we expect from films.